Dear students, I want to explain the types of projections and about the projection of the point. At first, about the type of projections. What is the projections? For the projection requires projections device. Projection device consists of the projected points. This A point must be projected, and projections source or center of the projections and plane of projections. After the projection process, projection of the point A on the projection plane P carried out. For the obtaining, for the finding of the projection given point, we must join the projection center point S with the center with the point on the space A, and after extending these lines, find intersection point to the plane. This point is projection of the given point on the space. These lines call it as projection line or projection ray. There are different type of projections. Projections will be rectilinear projections and curvilinear projections. Mainly use the rectilinear projections. These projections is parallel projections. There are three type of parallel projections. First is central projections. This is also call it as conic projections, and second is oblique projections, or maybe name it as parallel projections, and orthogonal projections. Orthogonal projections is the projection at the right angle. In this figure, given the central projections, S is projection point, center of the projections. ABC is curvilinear projected object in this space, and all projection rays started from this center of the projections and take through the point intersected the projection plane, and gives it is points. C1 is projection of the point C, B1 for the point B, and E1 for the projection B. If projection ray is parallel each other, this type of projections call it as parallel projections. In these projections, projection source or center of projections infinitely the long direction from the plane of projections. If this angle, angle between the rays of projections and plane of projections is 90 degrees, I mean that right angle, this type of projections call it as rectilinear projections or orthogonal projections. In this figure, we see that projected line AB, for the finding of the projection of the line AB, we must draw the projection ray from the point A and B and find it is intersection point with the projections of plane. And in this figure, given projections of the triangle ABC on the plane, This is also the conic projection methods, which projected 1, 2, 3, 4 points, one of them behind of the center of the projections. This is point D. For the finding of the projection given point, we must join the given point to the center of the projection and extend this line, which call it as projection ray. This we'll find the intersection point on the plane. This point is called as projection of the point, given point D is point, projection of the point D. And in this point, there are two points, B and C, because these points coincide, projection of this point coincide, because these points lay on the one projection rays, B and C. Next, about the properties of the projections. We know that projection of the point is point. A point in the space with the given direction of the projections determines the location of the single projection of the point on the plane of projections. A projection of a point is, but does not determine the place of the point in the space. For example, in this figure, from the projection of the point on the plane P, it is difficult to find the place of the projection in the space. This place may be is here, or is here, or is here. Okay. Projection of a straight line is also a straight line, but when projection of the straight line, which coincide with the direction of the projections, it is projection is point. In this figure, AB is a line, and this line lie on the projection ray, because it is projections is point. When line is perpendicular to the projection plane, in the orthogonal projection, it is projections is point. Projection of the straight line segment or plane figure, which is parallel to the projection planes, appears in equal length or as an concurrent figure, respectively to the position, to the type of the projections. Projections of a point, the projection of the point, divided the spatial line segment in a certain proportion. Divides the projections of segment in the same proportions in this figure. This in this figure, proportions of A car, A wing car, I A1 and K1, and KB and K1, B1, is equal. In orthogonal projections, the length of the projection of the segment, which is not parallel to the plane of projections, is less than the true or actual length of that segment. If in this figure, this is given line, and this is the projections of the given line. Length of the projection line is less than length of the real line. If a plane figure coincides with the projection direction, its projection is a straight line segment. Look at this figure, which in this figure given plane flat object AB and is perpendicular to the plane of projections, its projections at this forms at this straight line. For the finding of the projections of the details, we will use the methods with the essence of these methods is methods of Gaspard Monge. These methods call it as the concept of octant. If we take a three plane with the plane, this plane is H from the horizontal world, horizontal plane, V from the vertical plane, and W, this is profile plane. If three planes intersected in the space under the right angle, these planes divided the space 8 octants. First octant, this is the first octant, this one behind of the plane V, second octant, and below the horizontal plane and behind V is second octant, below the horizontal plane H, and in front of vertical plane V is fourth octant. In this five octants in these rules, and 8 octants, 6 octants, and 7 octants may be carried out. In this figure also show the octants of the projection. A three-dimensional geometrical model of projection of a product is transformed in these forms into the two-dimensional projections. Why? At these forms, we set as first octant, look at this first octant, which in front of vertical plane and above the horizontal plane, and profile plane is left hand side. If we take the first octant and take the point on this octant A, its horizontal projection calls it as A1, frontal projections A2, profile projections is AC3. How we can find the projections of the point? For the projections methods, we take the projection rays which perpendicular to the projection plane. In this figure, this is P1 is horizontal plane, which this projection rays is perpendicular to this plane, and P2 is frontal plane, this line AA2 is perpendicular to frontal plane, and this P2 is profile plane, and this line AA3 is perpendicular to the profile plane. This relationship shows in the left hand side of the slide. Sometimes it is enough to show using say two projections of the point. In this regard, given only two projections of the points A, given horizontal plane and vertical plane, and this is horizontal projection of the plane A, this is A dash it is frontal projection of the plane of the point A, which this point A on the point P. This is first octant and projections of the point A, given the first octant, horizontal projections is small letter a, frontal projections on the plane of plane which called V is frontal projections, and profile projections on the plane W is called as profile projections and denoted as A double dashed. If we rotate the planes, if we rotate the horizontal plane below and right and for a file plane for the right hand directions, we will give these figure. We obtain this figure. In this type of projections, representation of the projections called at complex drawing. On the complex drawing, horizontal plane for the first quadrant must be given, must be below the x zero lines, the axis, and vertical plane above the x zero axis. Vertical plane, I mean that profile plane above the x y axis, and right on the right hand side of the z zero axis. Okay, in these situations, these lines is 45 degrees, under 45 degrees. This line is equal to these lines or one. If we rotate these, we obtain the position of the point. Okay, for the for the first quadrant, we see that direction of the x-axis is plus, y-axis is also is plus, z-axis is also is plus. But for the third octant, x-axis plus, y is minus, and z also is minus. Third octant or third and angle projections mainly use it in the USA. In this figure, we on the left hand side see the projection of the point in the space, which there are three projection of plane F, H, and P, and this is middle sections is complex drawing of the point, and on the right hand side also the complex drawing, but simple complex drawing. We deleted the plane of projections. In this figure, there are no projection planes, and name it is F, P, or H. But when we look at these forms, we must know that this is horizontal projections, this is frontal projections, and this one is profile projections. Position of the point on the quadrants, which quadrants? And there are three type of position of the point, which we call it as general position of the point. When point place it on the space and not coincide any of the projections planes, and this plane point, this projected point, is not belong to any of the planes of projections. This is maybe frontal projections, horizontal frontal projections plane, horizontal projection plane, or profile projections planes. Maybe point belong to any plane of projections. In these situations, the place of projections calls that spatial position of the point. For example, in this spatial view of projections, let us define the position of the point. Well, this is first octant quadrant, the first of quadrant, and this is second quadrant, this is third quadrant, and this one is fourth quadrant. What is the quadrant? If two planes intersected under right angle directions, these planes divided the space into four space. This is called as quadrant. Look at the point A. Point A is here on the first quadrant. It is frontal direct projections is here, but frontal projections is above the x0 line and horizontal projections below the x0 line. When point is first quadrant, it is vertical projections in front of frontal plane, and horizontal projections is above the horizontal plane. When point is B, look at point B. In these situations, point in the spatial positions. Point is general positions. Point B here, point on the second quadrant, above the horizontal plane and behind the vertical plane. In these situations, when plane of projection horizontal planes is rotated. Clockwise directions, it is frontal projections is above the xy axis, place it above the xy axis, x0 axis, and horizontal projections also above the x0 axis. When point is third quadrant, this point C is third quadrant. Look at it is frontal projections must be below the horizontal plane, but vertical plane, vertical projections is behind of the frontal plane, because it is horizontal projections place it on the above the x zero line axis and frontal projections below the x zero axis. Let us find point D. Point D is first quadrant, and it is for the first quadrant. Projections, horizontal projections and frontal projections, both of below the x0 axis. these four points A, B, C, A, B, C, D is general positions of the point. But next point is the spatial positions. For example, find the point E. Where is the point E? Point E lie on the horizontal plane. This is belong on the horizontal plane because it is horizontal direct projections coincide with this same point E and E, and frontal projections lie on the X zero axis. This is horizontal frontal projections of the point E, because on the complex drawing, horizontal projections of the point E in the spatial positions lie on the XY axis, frontal projections, but horizontal projections below the XY axis. Let us look at the next point, point F. F. Where is the F on this space? This is also is here on the horizontal plane, but behind of the vertical plane, frontal plane. Because when horizontal plane is rotated, it is horizontal place. Place it on the above on the X0 axis. F1, this is horizontal projections. But frontal projections lay on the X0 axis. On the X0 axis. And next point is Q. Where is the Q? Q, this is on the, we see that this point is on the frontal plane. Above the side of the frontal plane, Q, because it is frontal projections coincide with the projections of the same point, K, double dash it. And horizontal projections raise on the X0 axis. When point is on the frontal plane, but below the horizontal plane, this is point M. This point belongs to the horizontal plane because it is belongs to the frontal plane because it is frontal projections coincide with the same point. M is coincide M. But horizontal projections must be on the X0 axis. At this one. When point, this point, N. Where is the point N? When point lays on the intersection line of the plane, on the coordinate axis, it is both projections, horizontal and frontal projections, must be lie on the X0 axis. Okay. There are some law of projection, projective connections. The first law of projection connection is that frontal projections of the point, frontal and horizontal projections of the point lays on the same projection line, and this line is perpendicular to the X0 axis. This is first law of the projections. The second law of projections, or second law of projective connections, maybe call it that this word. Frontal and profile projections of the point A are located on the same line of projective connections to which is perpendicular to the axis OZ. The third law of projective connections is that horizontal and profile projections of the given point A are located on the same polygonal line of projective connections 3, 3. This maybe at this one. Okay. Thank you very much for the attention. Next lecture about the projections of the line.